Hello guys, and welcome, hold on, there you go, welcome to the season premiere of the OwnerCast Season 2, all that jazz. We have four wonderful guests with us tonight. First off, we have the guy from Metal Gear Solid, the Metal Gear Solid subreddit, Ephraim. How you doing, buddy?
Thank you, sir, I'm doing great.
We have Mr. Master of Memes, Lewis.
Damn right.
Yes. And we have, as always, the wonderful Bane for you. How you doing, buddy?
Yo. Tired, excited, watching The Flash at the same time while I'm talking to you guys.
Awesome.
Season 2 for that as well.
And Mr. Wintergate will be here shortly. Just casual. Oh, how you guys doing tonight?
Good. Like I mentioned before we started recording, I just moved, and if any guys from Reddit are listening, our podcast will be starting up again here shortly, so I'm excited about that, and other than that, things are good.
And we have Mr. Wintergate Operative. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, I'm doing fine. I was just testing out some borderless PS4 streams because someone told me how to cut that off. So
okay.
I was just testing that real quick. And Metal Gear Online, oh man, there's a lot to talk about there, but I'll get to that later.
I haven't got to play it.
It's all right. It's just some stuff that's very overpowered, like the Walker Gears. The when you get into Metal Gear and you just slice through people to shreds, it's crazy.
Yeah, we actually we had one of our guys go out there over the weekend. Konami sent us a message and asked for a couple of our guys to go out, and my friend Salad Snake went out to LA and he got like a whole day with it and had you know, all kinds of fun with it. He loves Metal Gear Online.
Holy crap, really?
Oh yeah. Yeah, we actually we've done quite a few things with Konami. Actually, they sent our moderators to E3. They got our creator of our subreddit, Killer Zite. She got to go to the boot camp, so she got a couple days with the game before release. And yeah, they've actually done a lot of stuff with us. They've been great.
Oh, that's awesome!
I really hope they don't listen to the last two episodes of podcast I've been on.
Oh God! Oh.
Yeah. Hashtag fuck Konami Island. Yeah. There's a much longer story in that one.
I remember that. Yeah. I mean, well, I'm not. I can honestly say I'm not a fan of the whole pachinko slot business, but I do appreciate how Metal Gear Online is. I mean, I think that for what I played, I had fun with it. Just some overpowered perks are here or there, and I don't like cloaking at all. I think that anyone uses that invisible perk, they should just be flogged or something, because I don't like it.
They have stealth camo?
Yes, they have a whole entire perk dedicated to stealth camouflage.
Oh, God.
Yep.
Okay.
I've seen that.
Well, it's also, you know, the first couple days, too. I'm sure, you know, once people get some time with the game, they'll figure out the neat ways around that and how to combat that. And before you know it, those things are going to be pretty much useless.
Well, there's only one way now. Just get in the Walker gear, and that's it.
I do think there should have been something like a public beta to kind of test it out.
Yeah, because they could have eliminated just some of the problems that they have. I just think that if they're going to have the Metal Gears be like that, they should be able to take more damage before you decide to get out of them. I mean, maybe like one or two clips and that'll be it.
Magazines. Sorry. What?
Oh, you're one of those people.
I am, because it's accurate. I'm sorry.
Mr. Politically Correct.
No, it's just actually correct.
I know.
I will say this though. I will say, from what I've seen, my copy, I let my cousin borrow it, so I fucked up with that one. It looks enjoyable. It looks really fun. Of course, I've got so many different multiplayer games this year that I'm going to basically be balancing between that and, you know, Halo and just everything else. I do like the idea of a class system though they have, but I'm not sure how stealth works in that game, well, online version of the game. So
Stealth is good, but you will see some dumb teammates. Like, I saw a guy that literally, like, I was in a cardboard box. He literally ran past me, and everyone knows, like, you use a cardboard box, someone must be in there. Some guy ran past me, didn't even see me. I poked up and killed him, shot him.
Well, I think what's going to be, speaking of which, you know, like everyone, you know, assumes that there's someone in a cardboard box. I think one of the good strategies that will probably emerge as the game goes on is people using decoys. Salad, our friend that went and played the beta, he was, or not the beta, just the, you know, the open play, he was telling us about people that would get into the cardboard box or a smoke box and then dive out of it, and so they pretty much set up a decoy to attract people to it.
Yeah.
I did see decoys, yeah, that does exist.
Okay. Renegade.
Yeah.
Did you beat Metal Gear Solid 5?
Unfortunately, no. It's a pretty long game. Not everyone is going to get through it, like, their first time just lickety-split, especially if you're getting, like, a lot of other games in the process. If you have a giant backlog, there's no way you're going to beat Metal Gear Solid 5 in, like, the span of 3 days or a week or something.
Have you been spoiled yet?
I have, actually. Unfortunately, some people won't shut up.
I'm
going to strangle them.
I have not, I'm going to dip out until you, because I think you guys are going to start talking spoilers now, right?
Oh, I see you later, Wayne.
Send me a DM on Twitter. You know what to do. All right.
All right, see ya. So, yeah, we're going to talk about the story real quick.
All right, I'm going to mute because I do not want to hear this. Just, you know, tweet me or whatever and say when it's over, okay?
Okay, so.
All right.
See ya. So, that's three.
No problem.
Okay, no problem. Ephraim and Lewis, if you've seen it, what did you guys think about the story?
Overall?
Yeah, overall.
It's absurd.
I pretty much had to beat it within a couple days just for the stuff that I do for the subreddit. Like, I do a weekly article and stuff talking about predictions that people had and... obviously, I do the podcast, so I kind of torched through it really fast, which I do regret a little bit, but I thought the overall story was kind of weak, actually. I thought the ending was one of the best endings I've ever seen in Metal Gear, but the story itself felt almost empty a little bit. Like, I'm fine with there not being as many cutscenes, and I'm fine without there being as much dialogue, but... I felt there wasn't enough character development. I thought that the characters stayed where they were, and my podcast partner, Flash, he'll debate me at no end to this, I'm sure, when we get ours up and rolling again. In his eyes, you know, one of the themes was the characters are kind of stuck where they are, and I do appreciate that viewpoint. But for me, I'm so used to just getting so wrapped up in a Metal Gear Solid story and having the story move me and, you know, feel emotions, and I didn't really feel much when I was playing through the story of Metal Gear Solid 5.
Yeah. Lewis, do you have any take on it?
That's funny, no.
Nope.
I don't know much about the Metal Gear franchise, just nanomachines.
And parasites. That's all you need to know about Metal Gear.
Yes, yes, the parasites, or the nanomachines have been replaced by parasites.
Yes.
What the fuck?
Parasites is the cause of everything in history.
And I actually took great, I did not like the fact that they used the parasites to explain away a lot of the powers of the Cobra unit from Metal Gear Solid 3.
Yeah. I didn't like that either. I thought it was a retcon.
Right. It feels like the Medichlorians explanation from Star Wars Episode 1. Like, it takes away the mystique and, I feel like, what makes a lot of the characters so intriguing in Metal Gear Solid 3.
Right. I did not like that part at all. I thought it was just a klutz. You know, like, nanomachines and MGS4. Everything was caused by nanomachines. Oh.
Exactly.
Man, walk on water. Oh my god, that was nanomachines.
Like, what did you think of the ending, though?
The ending? Oh, man. Oh, man. Let's see. I did not like that I didn't play as the boss.
That is a very popular opinion.
I wanted to play as Big Boss, you know? I want to play as a real Big Boss, not some dude, you know?
And that's the interesting part of it, too, though, is that dude isn't necessarily just Venom Snake. That dude is you.
Right. And I didn't want that, though. You know? I didn't want that. I wanted Big Boss, the real Big Boss, kicking Stofus' ass, you know?
And I did, too. And I think... let's say the ending was taken out. Let's say right. The whole Venom Snake thing didn't happen. I still don't feel like I would have been fully satisfied with the story because I got spoiled about halfway through about Venom Snake. But even before I got spoiled, I didn't really feel like I was playing as Big Boss, and I didn't really feel like this was the story that I was looking forward to. Not necessarily that, oh, what I expected didn't happen, but it was more that I didn't get as much out of it as I was hoping to.
Right. Martin3DD says, why does it matter if it's the real Big Boss? For all intents and purposes, he is Big Boss. I guess I can see your point, but at the same time, he's clearly a different person from Venom Snake.
I respectfully disagree about that.
Okay. So,
I think that, Flash, when we were discussing it, put it best to me that Ocelot was Venom Snake is as much Big Boss as Ocelot was Liquid in Metal Gear Solid 4.
That's a pretty
good. I mean, he's got the memories, he's got the skill, he's got the look, and the way that the real Big Boss explained it at the end was that they're kind of, you know, two parts of the same person at this point. And, I mean, don't get me wrong, I understand your frustration. I'm not trying to negate that at all. But at the same, like, and don't get me wrong, like, I was, when I found out about it, I was pretty disappointed because of all, like, the, my weekly thing is gathering up old theories that people had, and one of the things I was banking on, like, when it was leading up to the release, I was like, look at all these stupid people that think we're not going to be playing as Big Boss.
Yeah. We're playing as Blue Fox.
Oh my god. Yep. Python like, Selkin.
I mean, that would have been cooler. Gray Fox.
Do what?
I think it would have been cooler if we played as Gray Fox instead of Venom Snake, but that's just my opinion.
Yeah, I can see that. I would have really liked Gray Fox to at least made an appearance.
Right.
I mean, the timeline fits. They're in Africa. It was in the 80s that Big Boss rescued Frank Yeager and met Naomi Hunter, and I think Sniper Wolf happened in that time, too, and, you know, not necessarily in Africa, but certainly in the Middle East.
Right. Exactly. I guess it fits the timeline. What does you think of Venom Snake being killed in Metal Gear 1 instead of Big Boss? Did you like it? Did you not like it?
I did kind of like that. It got me more interested in the story of Metal Gear 1 and 2, and it kind of... I didn't really like it in Metal Gear 2 when Big Boss just kind of showed up and he was like, "Ha-ha, I'm alive after all, even though the entire fortress came down upon me." Like it does kind of negate some of that like campy stuff that happened. Yeah. And so I did like that, and I do like that it tied into Metal Gear 1 a lot, because I felt throughout Metal Gear Solid 5 that I wasn't really connecting to the rest of the series at all. Like, it felt like kind of its own thing, so I did like that it did that callback. Yeah. What about you?
I liked it.
Right on.
It fits the timeline, I guess. It explains why Big Boss miraculously survived a nuclear explosion. I'm like, what? You're still alive?
Absolutely.
So I liked it. I think it fits. What did you think about the gameplay?
Amazing.
Yeah.
Absolutely amazing. I love, I mean, I had my complaints. Like, sometimes I'll run up to a cargo container and, like, the Fulton thing won't pop up, like, immediately when I run up, and then I'll mess up and get shot.
Yeah, I actually died. Because I was trying to, like, you know, hit the prompt, and I actually fell and died. So
I believe that.
Oh, my God.
I absolutely 100% believe that.
Well, was it say that it's game of the year, at least in terms of gameplay?
Ooh, in terms of gameplay, I want to say yes so far. It's very polished gameplay. The setting and the architecture and everything of the world looks absolutely amazing. It's hard to say at this point. I mean, there's been a lot of really good games this year. You've got Batman Arkham Knight, which I thought was absolutely incredible.
Except on PC.
Yeah, except on PC, where it was, like, completely unplugged. I don't even know if they ever even did fix that at this point.
It looks like it's going to be released at the end of the month.
Oh, great. Took them long enough. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely got some stiff competition, and I think it's going to depend on who's judging, really, because I think that the cut content, or the quote-unquote cut content, you know, like, we don't really know the extent of that or how much there was, and the whole Venom Snake thing could potentially leave a sour taste in a lot of people's mouths. And to be honest, I was actually, like, I wouldn't give it a 10 out of 10 like a lot of the reviewers did. Yang Yi, he's really popular in the Metal Gear Solid fandom. He gave it a 10 out of 10. IGN, GameSpot, they all gave him, you know, absolutely incredible ratings. And myself, you know, because I'm so about the story of Metal Gear, I'd probably only give it like a 7.8 or an 8 out of 10 myself.
I gave it an 8.9.
Right on. Yeah, I mean, I agree with that more than I do most of the reviews that I see.
I wouldn't give it 10 out of 10 because the story was incomplete and it was weak. The only reason it would get a high rating was because of the gameplay.
Absolutely. And have you heard about, like, the search for the Chapter 3?
Yes.
What do you guys think about that?
What do you think about that, Lewis? If it's still there.
Think about what?
Chapter 3, Metal Gear Solid 5. Everybody's been looking for a month now.
I just finished Chapter 3 in The Lord of the Flies.
Good enough.
Do you think that there's going to, like, there is a Chapter 3 to find, or do you think that they're kind of just grasping at straws?
Yeah, they're just grasping at straws. I don't think there's going to be.
It's going to be real in, like, 6 months when they make DLC for it.
DLC.
If there is a Chapter 3, it will absolutely be DLC. Like, I don't think there can be anything on the disc.
It's not going to be like, hey, you get Chapter 3 for free.
Yeah, like, oh, all of a sudden we tricked you guys. You know, you had to put the disc in upside down and then scan it with a blue light, and then that's how you unlock Chapter 3. Congratulations, you cracked the code.
Was it on your subreddit? I saw people that were like, so soon for Chapter 3 on the PC version?
Absolutely, yeah. Okay. It was, I think it was our subreddit where a couple of the PC guys were going through the files and they found the title card for Chapter 3, and that spawned a whole new subreddit. There's reddit.com/r/neverbegameover, and it's an entire subreddit of people that are absolutely devoted to finding Chapter 3. And, you know, I have to hand it to them. They've found, like, there's a couple really cool strategies that people have found, you know, with, like, the scrambled tapes and Ground Zeroes and the scrambled tapes and Phantom Pain. And supposedly, you know, there's code that suggests that there could be a third one, and, you know, the theory is that that could unlock Chapter 3. But then, after they got past that, it's turning into, you know, like, use the disc as a frisbee, exactly, like, for three throws, and then let it skip on the ground twice, because there is Solid and Liquid Snake, and that's two twins, and then you put it in your PS4, and Chapter 3 will be unlocked.
Yeah.
Nice.
I'm like, wow. I mean, I don't think it's going to happen. Maybe they'll put it in, like, a DLC.
That's the only way I could see it happening, but I personally don't even see that happening.
I didn't notice that there's a part of the game that's missing, because on the PC version, it was supposed to be 28 gigabytes, and it ended up being 20.
Correct.
So unless that's all MGO, there's a part missing.
There is, and there was definitely going to be, like, I got the collector's edition, and it came with a Blu-ray, and it had, like, the trailers and some behind-the-scenes stuff, and they give you, not necessarily Chapter 3, but they show you what Mission 51 was going to be. And I don't know if you guys have seen the videos for that or anything, but it, like, as you know, if you've played the game, Eli escapes with Sal Helanthropus. And then they just don't really revisit that for the rest of the game. Just Eli escaped with the parasites and a walking weapon of mass destruction. And they're like, oh, okay, well, that's the end of that. And on the disc, it shows Venom Snake traveling to another part of Africa. He fights Sahelanthropus. Mm-hmm. The Diamond, like the whole battalion of Diamond Dogs, helps him. He defeats Eli slash Liquid, and like they have a really cool little moment together where you can just see the hate that Liquid has be born for Big Boss, mm-hmm. and then Big Boss escapes, and then that's the end of that. So I mean, there is definitely going to be more to the story, whether that be a whole chapter three or not. But there was definitely going to be more of a wrap-up to the Eli and Sahelanthropus storyline.
Yeah, because if I remember correctly, in the base game, Liquid takes Metal Gear to Metal Gear and just does it.
Yeah, correct.
So I'm like, what happened to Liquid? What happened to the kids? What happened to, I can't pronounce it, but Sahelanthropus?
Yeah, that's a toughie.
We'll go with that.
But yeah, it's like if you didn't have that extra little disc, you're like, I guess they were just okay with that, and maybe they crashed at sea, and Liquid lost Sahelanthropus, and that's why he needs Metal Gear Rex and Metal Gear Solid 1.
I guess. So that's kind of weird.
It was, and I didn't really care for Sahelanthropus overall, to tell you the truth. I thought it was too advanced for the 80s.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. It has a flaming whip. And, you know, a robot penis. And I'm like, what?
What?
Yes,
what
is Metal this? Gear Megazord.
Yeah, exactly. So, who was your favorite buddy in the game?
Obviously, DD or Quiet.
Mm-hmm. Quiet, huh?
Only because I liked having a human with me. I'm not gonna lie. Her, you know, tits moving around all the time was pretty awesome. But that's, you know, aside the point. Like I did feel a little bit of companionship with Quiet because I used her a lot, and mm-hmm. she was with me on pretty much every mission. So I mean, I thought them taking her out of the game completely, was a really cool way to give you an actual Phantom Pain.
I didn't mess her out because I was scared. So I never masked her out. Therefore, I never saw that sour cutscene, unfortunately.
Oh, so you never lost her?
No, I never lost her.
You lucky person.
So, yeah, I just used D-Dog most of the time.
He's beast.
Yeah, he's awesome.
Do you guys use D-Walker a lot? He's actually a lot of fun to just roll through and just, like, mess stuff up.
I used D-Walker in Mission 29.
Which one was that?
The one where you had to kill all the...
Skulls.
Yeah, the skulls.
Yes, that's by far the best place to use D-Walker.
Yeah. That was amazing. Also hard. I died a couple of times.
Yeah, I needed some help with that one. We've got a chat room for some of the regular people in the subreddit, and I got on there. I was like, how the hell do you do this? And one of my buddies was like, dude, just use D-Walker. Yeah. And so I hopped in D-Walker and then got it like one try on that.
Yeah. I thought like 20 times before I used D-Walker.
Yep, same here. And it's like, do you want to use the chicken hat because you suck at this game?
No!
It's like, no, I don't want to use the chicken hat. F off!
Do you want to use the other hat, but you won't get a rank at all? No! Shut up!
Are you guys going to go for the 100%?
Probably not. Because it's too hard. Did you guys play the Wii Hats missions?
Yes. The only one I have left is the Extreme Sahelanthropus, and I am definitely going to do the 100% for Phantom Pain. I'm not as thrilled about the other ones to do it, but at this point, it's the last Metal Gear Solid game that I have to get the Platinum Trophy, mm-hmm. so I have to just finish off the series.
I just did the important missions, and just because I heard, I saw in your subreddit that people were saying that it was, you know, we have missions.
And it was.
Yeah.
So, it absolutely was.
So I just did all the important side ops and the missions. And eventually I got to the last mission of the game. Did you like Mission 46?
Which one was that?
The one where you had to go through the tutorial stages all over again.
Oh, the truth.
Yes.
I I kind of knew what was coming, and even before I got it spoiled, like, I kind of was starting to pick up on what was going on, because, I mean, the whole thing with Ishmael at the beginning, like, kind of pointed me, I was like, okay, are we really playing as Big Boss? And then when you see the AI pod, you know, it scans Snake, and it's like, Jack, oh, it's not you, is it? Or Snake, oh, it's not you, or, you know, whatever the pod said. So I kind of figured it out before it got spoiled. And so when I got to mission, I think it was 46, you said, I was kind of just like, okay, here we go. But I thought they did it in a cool way of kind of like slowly revealing it to you.
Yeah.
I don't necessarily know if I liked playing through the entire intro again.
Yeah, I hate it. Like, I already played it once. Why do I need to play it again?
And it was like 2 o'clock in the morning for me or something like that. And I was like, okay, come on, like I want to get to the end. Come on, I don't want to have to do all this again.
Yeah, it was the same time frame for me.
Mm-hmm.
I was playing it pretty much all day, and I was like, I finally got to the ending. And what? I have to go to the tutorial mission again?
Now, have you played Metal Gear Solid 2?
Yes, I did.
Did you play it when it like came out, or did you already know you were going to be playing as Raiden?
I didn't play Metal Gear Solid 2 until a couple years ago.
Okay, right on. It was actually Metal Gear Solid 5 kind of does like the same kind of thing that 2 did. Uh-huh. 2, because I mean, Raiden is essentially the player, just like Venom is, and like the whole speech at the end, like, you know, was this real or not? You decide for yourself. And, you know, Raiden sheds the identity of the player to kind of go off and be his own person.
Right.
And Venom was kind of like a more extreme version of that, I thought, kind of breaking the fourth wall. And I thought that that was very well pulled off at the end of Mission 46. Mm-hmm. But like you said, like I didn't want to go rehash the whole freaking thing again.
Right. I actually ended up dying a couple of times because I forgot how to play the tutorial. So I actually died because, you know, when the headlights show up, I kept, like, getting caught, and they kept sitting me.
I hated it. No, I don't blame you, because, like, you play through the whole game as Venom at this point, being an ultra badass.
Yeah, wait.
And then you go try to do that in the tutorial, and you'll get lit up pretty quick.
Wait. Let's see if I have any other spoiler questions for you guys. What was your favorite mission in the game?
I'm going to let our other friend over here answer that while
let me add the other two back in.
Yeah, right on.
And
I like the mission where you can use the cardboard box.
Oh, yeah, that mission was great.
Yeah, I liked the mission with Snake.
Never get tired of it.
I think mine might have been the one before the Sahelanthropus fight when you...
We had to sneak in the base?
Yes, exactly. The way Flash put it, and I agree with it a lot, is like that was almost like a contained little mini Metal Gear Solid 1. Like, I really miss the base, like the big base infiltration in Metal Gear Solid 5, you know, whether it be Shadow Moses or Big Shell or Groznygrad. I really, really miss that. In 5, like having a big base to, you know, like study and figure out the guard patterns and, you know, like feel like you're in this big fortress. Yeah. I think OKB-0 was the only area in Phantom Pain that was like that.
Yeah.
Hey, back.
Welcome back.
Welcome back.
We were just discussing what was your favorite mission in the game so far.
Well, from what I played, I must say, I really liked the mission with the honeybee that you get, the rocket launcher? I think it was a great blend of stealth and action and escaping at the same time. It was a very surprising mission from what I played the first time around, so I had to say that one.
That was very well said. You're right. Like, it has a great mix of a lot of stuff that Phantom Pain has to offer, and it kind of just packs it up. And you get the big reveal there, too. Like, you see Skullface for the first time, Sahelanthropus, and, you know, what have you. It's a good answer.
And you have that crazy encounter with the skulls at the end, which was kind of funny how I just sort of outran them the second time around. I just sort of climbed on the side of the cliffs and just ran away.
What mission are you on right now?
I believe this. I'm on mission 30. I'm getting close. I'm getting very close to endgame.
You what?
I'm on mission 30.
Ooh.
Okay. Cool. I think that's the OKB, so I'm missing that FM was talking about.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that was actually my favorite mission.
Yeah, so you're getting close to the end of chapter 1, so.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and looking forward to chapter 2, where I did hear some things where you have to sort of replay some missions again on extreme, but I don't mind it at all. I just want to see for myself what I can get into.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you don't necessarily have to play those replay missions either. You can skip the vast majority of those.
Oh, okay, that's cool, actually, yeah.
Yeah, as long as you do the important side-ups, the important main-ups, you should be able to skip all of them.
Okay, that's good, because I was about to say, it's giving me DMC flashbacks all over again, DMC 4, where you go back through the game as Dante.
Oh, okay.
Oh. Yeah, and a lot of people view Chapter 1 as pretty much like the main story. And then chapter 2 is kind of like an epilogue just to wrap most things up without spoiling too much.
Mm-hmm. So, but I want to know something. How do you feel about the whole supposed chapter 3 and cut content? Do you think it was deliberate, or do you think they just didn't have enough time to really finish everything off?
Me personally, I don't forget, like, because there's a theory going around that they cut a lot of it out intentionally to give us a sense of Phantom Pain, but I don't buy into that at all, because that would mean that they spent months and money making content with the exact intent to not use it, and I don't see them authorizing that kind of spending to just cut something out and never use it.
Well, I'm back, by the way. I've got told the spoilers were gone. I'm just going to bring up words Silent Hills and just, hands are up now.
That does suck. That sucks hard. Because I'm a long time Silent Hill fan, and seeing the potential that series had, that's like right in the feels, man.
Being a Silent Hill fan at this point is like being tortured, but very slowly, by somebody who's really against you, but they don't really care enough at this point to even try killing you. You're just being tortured constantly by somebody who's like, I'm doing it because I want to.
Remember the scene where Angela was going up the burning stairway and James is looking at her and she says, "For me, it's always like this." Just imagine like her head with like the Konami logo or something, and I don't know, something crazy like that.
Yeah.
Bane.
Yes.
What mission are you on right now?
I'm really close to the end of chapter 1. I let my cousin borrow my copy, which I regret, but he's enjoying it, and he has a broken leg right now, so that's why I was like, sure, fuck it, have some enjoyable time.
Actually, Ben, you're not the only one I heard that got rid of their copy. Someone else did the same thing.
I did not get rid of my copy.
Well, just letting someone borrow the copy for like a temporary time. Someone else did that. Then I was like, oh man, well, you know, MGO came out today. He was like, oh, I got to scramble the Redbox now. So it's sort of like, you know, cut from the same cloth.
I might remind this weekend, because everything right now, I've got Destiny and all that. I've been playing a whole bunch of other games. I'm basically everything is leading up to Halo 5 for me. That day, I don't think anybody is going to see me outside of my house after I get back home from GameStop.
Recently, someone, gifted me Uncharted Nathan Drake Collection, so I'm probably going to give that a test run sooner or later. And I also have some other games that I haven't played yet. I know for sure that I haven't played any of these other games that I bought at a flea market, which is like Prototype 2. I haven't played that at all again. And I have some other ones in the closet. They're just everywhere. So, like, when you have a backlog, you just can't play one singular game. You're going to have a mindset where you want to do everything at a even pace, you know?
Yeah. I get that.
Yeah.
I think it's a great point. Like I said earlier, like, I was like extremely disappointed I didn't get to like really take my time with Metal Gear Solid 5 and kind of like set my own pace.
Me neither. My mindset is I really don't want to rush through the game, because I feel that rushing through a game sort of ruins the experience. The same thing happened to me with GTA 4, where it just felt like that playthrough, the first playthrough, was meaningless because I took like a week to try to rush through the game and beat it on time.
Yes.
Wow.
What by the way, I will say this. I enjoyed every moment that I had with Metal Gear Solid. I was actually impressed with how long the first chapter is, at least from where I was.
I think what got me was the intro. That was like an hour. Like, an hour went past actually playing that.
Yeah.
The intro may have been one of my... It's easily in my top five favorite moments of gaming. Certainly for the series. But the intro was just so amazingly well done.
Yeah. Definitely.
I can't stop listening to that cover of Man Who Sold the World now either. Like, it's on my phone. I listen to it like every day along with the David Bowie version of it. I'm obsessed with it.
Yeah, me too. I see I had it on during the pre-stream. So, yeah.
Very nice.
Yep, it was really good. Renegade and Bane, what did you guys think about the gameplay so far?
Very, very fluid and very enjoyable.
Mm-hmm.
I was almost impressed because I played for Ground Zeroes a lot, especially leading up to, Phantom Pain. And honestly, I was impressed with how smooth it was. Mm-hmm. It was genuinely a very fluid and enjoyable movement system, which is something a lot of games are having now, just in different ways. It really kind of did start with Titanfall in an odd way. Mm-hmm. I've noticed that. What else? And honestly, all of the movement with the horse and, D-Walker and stuff like that, mm-hmm. I enjoyed that. Also, Quiet accidentally picking out people I'm trying to suppress and extract.
Oh, God, we all have that problem.
Like, fuck, I needed this person. This person was useful to me. Why?
Why? It is best not to take Quiet as a partner unless you have, like, a tranquilizer on her. Yeah. Then it, becomes a little bit more easier.
Yeah. First few missions, did not know that.
I finally found an A+. And his brains are splattered all
over. Yep, right on the chest.
No. That was all for nothing.
Oh, look, an A+ guy. Oh, Quiet killed him. Never mind.
Whoop. Just imagine if people still didn't know that, and your heroism would go all the way up, and you get to the S-rank guys, and then she started capping those. You'd be so pissed.
Oh.
Yeah. We got some new followers on Twitch.
Ooh.
Let's see. Yeah. Tommy44 Fossetti. Thank you for following me. Welcome to the American Nation. Also, Victor375. Thanks for following me on Twitch. So, let's get into some gaming news here. Metal Gear Solid 5 sells 700,000 on Steam in 1 month. What do you guys think about that?
That's pretty good, actually.
Very impressive.
Indeed. I'm pretty sure this is already, and I don't have any figures to back this up. I'm just completely assuming here that this is probably the best-selling Metal Gear Solid game.
I would assume so, if we're counting Phantom Pain and Ground Zeroes, for sure. If we're not, I'm almost certain that it is, nonetheless.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, this game... It sold like gangbusters, nonetheless, at launch. I know they shipped at least... I think it's at least a total of 5 million they had to have shipped out, at the very least.
Uh-huh.
Let me see here. I'm going to pull up VG charts. I know it's not the best, most accurate, but... I mean,
I know our subreddit went off the charts. I mean, we've, quadrupled in size.
I noticed. Congratulations.
Yeah, it's been a little overwhelming for sure.
Yeah, when I was doing you guys were at, 10,000?
Somewhere around there, yeah.
Yeah, now you're at 70,000?
Yes, yeah, over 70.
I'm like, wow,
that's a
now.
Jump.
Yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, I'm not a moderator or anything, thank God.
Yeah.
Asked with, you know, he gets to deal with all sorts of fun stuff, but, yeah. I mean, we've been talking about just how more stressful it is, and, you know, I'm not trying to, you know, knock anyone, but, you know, the content has certainly changed a little bit. You know, we have a lot of dank memes now.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I bet Lewis is jerking off to that right now.
Yeah, there's a whole subreddit for that, if that's your thing. Meryl Rear Solid, you know, if that's your bag.
We need more memes.
Wipe this meme from the face of the earth.
Nah.
Such a lust for memes.
Now, I do have a question here. What does everybody think of that FOV insurance thing?
It's awful.
Oh, boy.
Clap.
FOV insurance.
It's awful.
Clap. Better now, luck next time.
Do you lose more stuff now, or is it just status quo?
I'm not entirely sure.
If I remember correctly, FOV insurance is if you get invaded, any men or resources that you lose, you get back? I'm not really sure.
If that's all that it is, because the post that I saw on the subreddit was talking about how someone lost, like, more than what they thought they usually did, uh-huh. And, you know, that would be absolutely horrendous. However, if nothing's changed there, if nothing changes about how much you lost or anything, I personally don't have too much of a problem with the insurance, because then, you know, if you're fine with it before, then just don't buy it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
Yeah, I thought it was, as horrible as it sounds now, I thought it was something a little bit more horrific, like, yeah, you could lose all your stuff, and it might screw you over, and what if you have to use microtransaction to get that stuff back? I think that would be the worst case scenario.
Yeah, that would be pretty crappy.
For sure.
Oh.
If you do lose more than before, you know, if you don't get the insurance, I do think that that's, like, one of the crappiest, shadiest business practices I've ever heard of, but...
Well, it's going out, man. So, Bane has a cuss word he likes to use.
Yes. Fuck Konami.
Yeah.
So, I'm gonna have no comment on that one. I am actually not, like, I mean, don't get me wrong, there's, like, a lot of stuff that I, like, don't like lately, but I'm not necessarily on the whole, like, hate on Konami bandwagon. And, yeah, I realize incredibly
I get, what you're saying. For me, I just dislike what they've been doing.
And I can't fault you for that.
especially as a Silent Hill fan. I've been a Silent Hill fan since the original. I got it in 2000. I still have a copy somewhere. I bought it pre-owned from a rental store. I still remember playing through it at a very inappropriate age for that game.
I'm so sorry about what happened. I was so looking for Silent Hills. And
If it was PS4 only, that would have made me honestly go out and buy a PS4 the moment they announced that.
Wow.
That's how excited I was. I'm one of those people that... I'm just not really... I don't want the PS4 until later on in its life cycle. Just so I can get some, you know, more games for it, because really all I want is Bloodborne. but that would have made me run out, buy one that instant. And... Yeah, fuck Konami. It's been a very hard time being a Silent Hill fan. But hey, we got the second movie and a pachinko machine. We should be happy. I can't say
that. That's such a... I mean, being such a huge Kojima fan and, like, a huge horror genre fan, like, I was disappointed by the departure of that game. I can't imagine what, like, a hardcore fan of Silent Hill must feel like.
It's almost about as bad as playing through Homecoming again.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. I'm one of those people who... I think that Shattered Memories and Downpour are genuinely pretty good. The rest of them are kind of... Especially Homecoming.
We don't talk about Homecoming.
We don't talk about it here. Book of Memories made a really good Diablo clone when Diablo 3 was being shitty, so that's a good part, but...
That's true. That's very true.
Yeah. No offline play. Fucking thanks, Blizzard. Anyways, Sorry about that.
That's cool. Twitch is sucking right now, so so hopefully we can get back to them eventually.
Alright.
But we can keep recording until we get back to on Twitch. What do you guys think about Arkham Knight finally coming back to PC this month?
No one cares for it at this rate on PC, I'm gonna be real with you guys.
Yeah, better luck next time. I've got a couple of things I'm assuming we'll get to today where I've got that saying for, so... Alright, here, I can knock one of my own off. Review of Fear of Walking Dead Season 1. Better luck next time. There you go.
Ooh,
sorry.
Yeah, I thought the first three episodes were amazing, and then I feel like it completely sloughed off.
Yeah. Still not as bad as Season 2 of Walking Dead. That's
true.
That's not hard, but... Anyways, yeah.
And Reyes, what do you think of Arkham Knight coming back to PC? To the sizzle.
I feel like it's late in the game, to tell you the truth. I feel like a lot of the people who were in it for the story, because, I mean, everyone knew it was going to be the conclusion of the Arkham series, and Arkham City left us on such a huge cliffhanger, spoilers, with the death of the Joker. And I think a lot of the people that were so invested in that story that got it on PC have by now just either bought it on a console or said, F it, and just watched a YouTube.
Yeah, it was way too late. If it took them all this time from... it came out in July, right?
It did.
Yeah.
Yeah, it took them all this time from July to October, then, yeah, I don't think that... Only, like, diehard Batman purists are gonna, like, really care for that game, but anyone else, they probably already moved on already, and there's so much to play that I don't think that they'll be able to squeeze that game in their schedule.
Yeah. I didn't even have a computer that could run it on the lowest settings, so I played it on the Xbox, and it was good, but wow, those issues should not have been anywhere near as prevalent as they were. I'm almost impressed.
Like
for the PC?
Yeah, for the PC.
Yeah.
Did you guys hear the news report saying that they knew that the PC version was broken for like a while now?
Really?
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow. That sucks.
That's messed up.
Yeah. Definitely.
Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me.
Well, it is like, it is Warner Brothers, so, I mean, because they did mess up Mortal Kombat X on PC, and then somehow Mad Max turned to be okay, but, yeah, they have not been striking out recently, and, I wouldn't say they're bad as the new Ubisoft and how terrible they've been doing, but it's still pretty close with how that game has been, like, delayed on PC, and they didn't have the opportunity to fix it. So, it sucks, but, at least they're doing it, and I'm sure it'll have an audience out there somewhere, but a lot of people aren't going to care.
Yeah.
Oh, speaking of Ubisoft, I hate to hijack this, but has anybody seen the trailer for Far Cry Primal?
I think I've seen little bits and pieces of it, yeah.
Could be intriguing. Could be garbage. I'm still gonna leave that to, the Far Cry Wii games they made. But, yeah, I bought one of those train wrecks on accident.
Yeah, I'm so sorry.
I think, personally, I would prefer Blood Dragon 2. I mean, I think that they should have made a sequel to that before. Just to test the waters and maybe have the opportunity to upgrade the engine and put that in that DLC, a standalone, and then they could go with Primal, but I don't know. It's kind of sketchy because this is a new release and it's coming out in February. It's coming out pretty soon, so, my fingers crossed that I hope it's good, but if it's not, then I won't be surprised because of the, time window.
I bet you it won't be good for the first, couple weeks.
Yeah, I would think that they probably need to patch it, or it probably will get delayed like everything else, because there was some stuff I was looking forward to this year, like Hitman, they delayed that, so they might just give this a delay and write it off as that.
I honestly wish more companies would delay more than they would just release broken products.
Yeah, yeah. that's better than just saying, okay, we got this out here. Now we have to put this ginormous, like, 3 gigabyte patch. And you're sitting there looking at it like, what the hell is this?
The new fucking Tony Hawk's game. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh.
What do you guys think about that game?
Good idea. Better luck next time.
He said he was going to use it a lot. The best.
Yeah.
Great idea. Terrible execution for sure.
Yeah.
They should have honestly waited. Not good execution. I've heard the soundtrack is also shit.
Wow, that's disappointing. That was like the best part of the old games.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. That was the best part. Listening to Superman back on the PS1 Tony Hawk, that was amazing.
Oh, yeah. You guys know that Metal Gear Solid 2, the original Substance release for 360 and PS2, had a Tony Hawk game in it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay.
that was the skateboarding, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and they did like a punk rock cover of the Metal Gear Solid theme. It was really, really cool.
Oh yeah, I played that. That was kind of awesome.
It's been so long. I'm pulling up the soundtrack. Let's see if there's anything decent on here. Oh.
All right, I'm gonna reset my connection real quick.
Oh.
Right. My internet went to crap.
You sound alright.
Gotta love that.
Yep, stupid Comcast. At it again.
You might need a new router as well.
Yeah. I don't know why it's doing that.
It's just a hamster running in a wheel. It seems fine to me.
You might need to replace the hamster.
Yeah, I think it's getting old.
Or just tase him a couple times. Okay. There's only two songs I can say I like on the soundtrack. Anti-Flag, Stars and Stripes, and Rat Attack, Cream on Chrome.
Oh, wow. I don't know.
That's actually pretty cool. That's the only two I can really say, like, fuck, that'll be fun to play. They have some good bands on here, but not really songs I enjoy from them. And there's a Skrillex song on here.
Oh, dear.
Better luck next time.
And we're back. We're back on Twits. Yay. I think.
That was quick.
Yeah. The car died. I don't know when it came.
Rip.
This is in.
It died for like a second or two, and then it came back.
Yeah. I bug skate mechanics. I'm sorry. My bad.
There's really only two good songs on the soundtrack. Whew.
I bet you'll find a lot more memorable music on the Twisted Metal soundtrack, the one that came out in 2012, than that piece of shit.
I've only played that once, and I kind of miss Twisted Metal in its old school ways. Favorite one was still Small Brawl.
They actually, what they did for PS Plus this month, because it kind of flew under the radar for me. I didn't know that it was free for PS Plus this month, so I went ahead, downloaded it, did a little Let's Play of it. I heard a lot of great songs, and I heard a lot of Rob Zombie stuff, which was, you know, I was kind of a fan of him back in the day, so I kind of liked that music. But in terms of this Tony Hawk game, it just wasn't appealing for me. Like, I saw the reviews, too. Like, I'm not usually the type of guy that bases his opinion off reviews. I'm like, I have to try it before I buy it, but everyone was saying it was just complete, like, dog shit, and I said, okay, I might want to stay away from it this time, because I looked at the gameplay, too, and it just wasn't really that great as the old Tony Hawk games. I think I'd rather play Underground, or I'd rather play the older ones than this one.
Yeah.
I'm watching... Okay, yeah, sorry, I'm watching the Flash still in the background, and...
Uh-huh. Is it good?
Oh, yeah...
Is it really good?
Yep. They, they're doing the Flash from Two Worlds storyline currently. Okay. Which, if you want me to nerd out in comic books a little bit, that's where the original, the Golden Age Flash meets the Silver Age Flash. Jay Garrick is the Silver Age, well, Golden Age, and Barry Allen is the Silver. And they even have the helmet right, and, sorry.
That's worth mentioning.
this season is pretty, pretty good so far, and it's only one episode.
Cool.
Yeah, okay, where was I?
what was I?
Yeah, this happens every once in a while.
We're having difficulties, so I think we're back now. Twist has been casual, so.
How many times did it crash? I'm out of a loop here.
I don't know.
I don't think I can count that high.
So,
are you guys excited for Fallout 4?
Yeah. In a weird way, I'm kind of also nervous for it. I also won't have the money for it for a very short while.
Yeah, I probably won't get it day one either, but as we all know, there's going to be spoilers like out of the ass. I already see it coming, so by the time I beat that game, everyone would already told me what happened.
Yeah.
Are you excited, F'em?
Yes, F'em. They're a bunch of idiots. F'em.
I rarely get games day one these days.
Me neither. It's like, if you have priorities, those are going to be obviously first.
Wait, of course. Oh.
No. I mean, it's going to be a little bit, it's going to be a little bit delayed for me. I'm waiting, of course, until the first bugs are ironed out, so we can find other bugs.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of bugs.
That's just
just the way it goes.
Good old Bug Festa.
Yeah.
I mean, look at it this way, Bane. I mean, you guys will be the first beta testers.
That's essentially what day oneers are these days.
Yeah. I do know, apparently some people have been saying, because they leaked the Halo 5 beta testing stuff, well, at least details recently. I've heard from people that I know who are personally beta testing it right now that it is running really fucking smoothly. They've been testing this since, I think, June for this one private system, and they said they've got basically all the shit fixed just so it doesn't pull another Master Chief Collection.
Oh, that was terrible. I hear nightmare stories about that.
Yeah, it was really hard being a Halo fan around that time.
And I'm actually going to have to interrupt you guys for a minute. I am actually going to have to get going for the evening.
Okay.
But thank you very much for having me on. It was an honor, and I had a ton of fun doing this.
Okay. Can you plug your podcast real quick?
Oh, yes. By all means, please.
What do you talk about on your podcast?
Exclusively Metal Gear Solid.
Okay.
Not surprisingly.
Metal Gear?
We focus a lot on the community of the subreddit. We get guests on from the subreddit a lot.
Cool.
We usually do a piece called the Subreddit Rundown, where we'll go through the top posts of the week. It's usually a weekly podcast. We took a break when Phantom Pain came out. A lot of it was speculation. We talk a lot about the themes and the characters and the goings-on behind the scenes of what goes into making the games. Hideo Kojima is like a huge focus of ours.
Oh, no, did the sound cut out for me?
Do what?
I said the sound just cut out for me.
Oh, my bad.
Were you talking just now?
I was listening, but then everything cut out.
Oh.
Oh, no, I'm still here. I don't know what's going on. It's like ghost stories, you know?
Yeah. You never know.
Yeah, that's basically the gist of the podcast. Okay. It focuses on Metal Gear Solid and the Metal Gear Solid subreddit community. It's called the Codec Moments Podcast. You can find us on iTunes and on YouTube. Our YouTube channel is the RMGS Media Unit. You can find us on there. It's myself and one of the moderators from the sub, Flash Medallion, that hosted.
Thanks for coming on.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Thanks for having me. It was a blast.
Yeah, it was awesome talking to you about the spoilers.
Yeah. Sorry. That was fun.
So, yeah, you guys are welcome to come anytime.
Yeah, for sure, man. Thanks.
Thanks for coming on, and I hope to see you later.
Yeah, you definitely will. You guys take it easy.
You too.
All right, see you later.
See ya. And that was Ephraim from the Metal Gear Solid subreddit. Yeah.
Oh, can I give a quick shout out?
Sure.
I need to pull it up here. Because I have it. Oh, here it is. Dave McCauley, I know you're probably actually maybe not watching us live. He mentioned that we had an enjoyable podcast when he rewatched the episode 20, and I figured I'd give him a shout out again here because, yeah. We need to have him as a guest on season 2. I'm just saying. He was really enjoyable.
Yes. He was absolutely amazing guest.
Because we, even a little bit of behind the scenes, I think we had like an hour and a half after the podcast ended, but we kept talking.
Hours. And then we played Quiplass.
Yeah. Well, I think I headed out for that one because I was like, oh no, I was playing with you guys, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was fun.
It was like, it ended like at 1 a.m.
Yeah.
It was so much fun. Yeah.
We need to do that again.
Yes, absolutely. Gabe was an amazing guest. Shout out to Gabe. He has his own MCN on YouTube, so.
Yep, Fuse 4.
Yep, Fuse 4. Shout out to Fuse 4. And also Moogle Master 102, who's also part of Fuse 4. Shout out to Moogle as well. Let's see. Did you guys hear about Havoc joining Microsoft?
I think, Microsoft did a very, very smart move. Mm-hmm. They did the same thing with Minecraft, which, you know, people say, oh, well, they got it a little too late and it's run. I said, no, they didn't. No, not at all. They're making money from the PS4, the PS3, the Vita, 360, Xbox One, PC, and now the Windows 10 beta. That's the smartest fucking decision they've ever done.
Yeah, definitely.
At least, you know, buying a third-party IP of anything. That was a genius idea. Havoc is also a genius idea.
Yes. Havoc is on every game ever created.
Yeah. I don't even think I have a game currently in my little drawer right here that doesn't have Havoc.
What?
Yep. There's at least... even Rare Replay has Havoc, so that's something.
Yep, definitely. Anyway,
I think that if they had to shell out money for it before, it's not going to be any different this time around. Only that Microsoft is, you know, they're definitely pocketing some money. But that's about it. That's how I feel about it. Supposedly, a lot of people were saying, you know, what about stuff like Uncharted? I don't think that... it's not going to really affect a lot of first-party games, especially if they have the money to go out and buy it. You know, they can license it and get the money back.
And it might even be, in the long run, cheaper for even Sony, because Intel, they charge a lot for certain things, and I'm not entirely sure what Microsoft's pricing plan is going to be, but, you know, that's something right there.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. Lewis, you got any thoughts on this?
I thought he just disconnected.
I'll call this off in like 2 seconds.
Behind the scenes.
Yeah.
It's a smart move, I think. The Havoc engine is used in like everything.
Ever. Yeah.
And, I mean... I think it's also smart because Microsoft is, they're doing, like, the cloud computing for, what was that, Crackdown 3, whenever mm-hmm. you're playing multiplayer, so that way everything can be destroyed. Mm-hmm. And Havoc is a very great physics engine, so mixing both of those together could be something we haven't seen before. I hate to sound like a fanboy there, but that's something that they could really do. But, yeah, there you go.
Crackdown 3 looks awesome.
It does.
It looks so good.
I have a feeling I'm just going to spend most of my time in co-op blowing everything the fuck up.
Yeah, I hope it comes to PC eventually.
I think it will, because you know, they have the cross-buy thing. I think for digital mostly, the cross-buy thing. Plus,
yeah, I would never say never, because Gears of War Ultimate is getting ported to PC.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I'm impressed with the steps Microsoft is taking to work on computer, but also keep Xbox viable. I mean, we're not going to see Halo 5 on computer for a very long time, because that's a big flagship title. I know at least 10 people buying an Xbox One just for Halo 5.
Wow.
Yeah. I was buying it for Master Chief Collection, to be fair. I did not know Master Chief Collection would be as broken as it was, but I was buying it for that.
Guys, if you have any questions for our guests, go to ask.fm/onocast. Or if I can want to put it in the chat right now. I said it in that earlier, but technical difficulties.
Let me ask you a question, Lester.
Sure.
Are you also going to do chat questions?
Yes.
Okay.
Chat questions, real questions. Any questions?
A couple seconds. Come on, one question. Maybe even a little one.
All right, I got an idea. Ask a question for Lewis, because he's been kind of quiet. Ask a question for him.
Yes, Lewis. Yes.
Let's deliver all of your questions to Mr. Lewis.
Yes.
Yes, that would be great.
I'll direct one while we wait for the chat to sync up to us. What have you been playing, Lewis?
Let's go away, Lester. let's see. I've been playing. See, I don't play many new games, so I've been playing like Pikmin 2 as of late.
Ooh, there you go.
It's really cool. Maybe I'll beat it this time.
For me, I guess I'll pose the same question myself. For me, it's an almost depressing amount of Destiny recently. on my my alternate account that I normally use to play with other people, not stream, I've finished the raid like 5 times since the raid came out. And honestly, don't know why.
For me, it's a lot of Last of Us. I gotta give a shout out to Tyler Hansen. He gifted me Uncharted and Battlefield 4.
Wow.
So, I'm going to try this out, and hopefully, you know, I don't have any complications, but I'm gonna try it out. And I've just been playing a lot of various games with, like, people and a cooperative experience, and I also been playing a lot of Last of Us. So, you know, been having a lot of fun just varying it up. I cannot be the type of person that just plays one game solitary like forever. There's some people that like
that,
but
yeah.
I can't do it personally.
Yeah.
I understand, even though I'm completely the one person who's doing it right now.
Yeah. I probably played just Metal Gear Solid 5 this whole month. I played
There's been Metal Gear Solid a little bit. When I can get a chance to play it. Destiny, and a little bit of Halo to kind of keep myself, you know, loose for Halo 5.
Alright, we've got some questions rolling in now. Holy crap. Got a lot of questions here. First question, anonymous. Ask the firm, why is Lewis such a weeb?
Ooh.
I'm not.
Alright. Lewis is not a weeaboo confirmed.
Yeah. Closet weeaboo instead, you know, he got to hide it in the public.
I have to blend somehow.
Next question goes to anonymous. Lester, why do you keep lying about the barbecue Doritos? Look, for the 1,000th time, I'm not lying about the barbecue Doritos. I'm showing you proof. Photographic evidence. Thousands of times, barbecue Doritos exist.
They're not real.
They are real, dude. What the crap?
They're real on different dimensions.
You had to hop in an alternate universe in order to get those.
like saying Canada is a country. It's not true. Not even real.
Canada is just a flat Canada space now? Of land.
We slandering Canada?
Is it slandering if it's facts?
Yeah, you know what? I'll go with that. I'll go and say Canada sucks, you know? They got horrible pancakes, horrible maple syrup, horrible poutine.
What the fuck is a poutine anyways? Poutine?
I don't know. It's a kind of weird, it's some weird alien yogurt that like Canadians like to rub all over themselves. I don't know.
It sounds like a weird sex act. There's no denying that one.
Yeah, they're some kinky bastards, those Canadians.
Maybe that does not surprise me.
Uh-oh.
Alanis Morissette. There Ooh. You go.
Vigla said, what the beep did you just say?
Uh-oh. Just on the chat, please don't start a U.S.-Canada war.
I noticed he was in the chat, so I was like, you know what? It's time for some slander.
Welcome to the Slandercast.
Slandercast confirmed, ladies and gentlemen.
Slandercast episode 1.
There we go. That's how we rebrand the new season. This is a reboot. Slandercast.
It's a reboot. The Eurocast. Not the Slandercast.
A reboot, eh? Oh no, I outed myself as possibly Canadian.
Exposed.
I'm a double agent. There you go.
Oh. It was you all along.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Barbecue Dorito, barbecue Lays, whatever. Barbecue Dorito Lays.
Wait, whoa, hold on, Bane, you're Canadian?
No.
Oh, okay, I'm about to... No. I almost had a heart attack for a second. I thought you were one of those weird androids from far away, I was about to say.
No, I live close to Michigan, that's basically Canada, but it's a different story.
America. The Night Mask asks, what do you guys think of KAF-14 new look?
King of Fighters 14?
I
don't know. A lot of people feel skeptical about the 3D look because it reminds them of Maximum Impact, and Maximum Impact wasn't that great to some people. I had never played it, so I can sort of dig it, but it looks very rough. Like, you see a lot of other fighting games out there, like Tekken 7 and, even Tekken 6. They look way better than this King of Fighters, so I hope that they had the opportunity to fix it, but it just looks very rough from what I see.
I hope it's good. I haven't played a King of Fighters game, oh god, and I want to say at least, like, 5 years? I'm not even sure. I used to like the series a lot. it just kind of fell out for me.
The latest entries have been good, though. Like, which the last one that came out, King of Fighters 13, I thought that was amazing. So definitely, if you want to pick it up again or you want to get back into the mix, I would suggest getting 13.
I'll have to give that. I've been playing a small amount of Killer Instinct off and on, and I'm still bad at the game, but I'm enjoying it a lot more than I did the first year it came out. Or first year I got to, technically second year it came out, first year I got to play it.
Another question. Lewis, what would you do if you were DSP for one day?
Only one day?
Oh, God.
Yeah, a day.
Alright. See, what I would do first is take a nap.
You taking that with Panda Leaf?
Fuck no.
Well,
skip over for you, Ren.
What if the
No, I am staying away from that AIDS infested dumpster bin at all costs.
Well, here's one rule. What if within 24 hours you actually had to have sex with Panda Lee? What would you do then?
He doesn't have the energy to do that.
You ever see that movie Cat Fever where, like, the guy's penis was falling off or whatever?
What?
The
I just
grabbed Fever.
Yeah.
Never seen it.
Yeah, I have.
Yeah, it would be like that. You had this weird sort of skin-eating disease after having sex with her.
I would just grab, like, a one of those Glad Force Flex trash bags, cut off a small bit of it, because, you know, DSP, and stretch it around whatever the tiny thing is, and, bite the bullet. I'll be back in my real body.
you know what, I'll just put a bag over her head, you know, it'll be over soon.
Two bags over her head, three bags over mine, and a clown of a background crying. There you go. That's the exact visual I can give.
So, Lewis, how would you sleep with Panda Lee? Do you want her, you know, you want her naked, you know, in the shower? Tell us your secrets.
As long as there's a wall separating us, she can do whatever she wants.
So it'd be glory holing it.
Oh, oh my god. Oh,
let's move on to the next question. somebody asked, why does Wynn want to get twice at Last of Us multiplayer?
I don't know. That probably is Cyber Iceblood. And first of all, he can suck a dick because he's the one who wants to use cloaking in Metal Gear Solid, and I think cloaking is for scrubs.
What a cock.
I agree with him though. I'll kind of agree with him like this. It's very hard to play that fucking multiplayer.
It's hard. It depends. Like, there's a lot. Nowadays on Last of Us, there's a lot of DLC for weapons, and there's some weapons that are better than others, and you obviously notice that if you buy them, but...
I remember playing on the PS3, and I don't know if it was a PS3 controller, because that thing and me clashed a lot, but, it was very, very odd to control.
Alright, next question. This is probably going to be the most controversial question.
Oh boy.
In the history of the Intercast.
Season, we're starting season out too strong. Ending technically season too strong. There we go.
The question is, are you guys ready? When is Wynnegade going to propose to Panda Lee?
Soon, Tina. Season 3 finale. There we go.
Season 3!
How about in the Twilight Zone?
In the Twilight Zone. Alright.
No, that doesn't count.
I think that's it. I don't think we have any more questions.
Do it, Ren.
Oh, no.
No, I saw another question. Hold on.
I value my loins. Thank you.
Why is Renegade such a casual four?
I don't know. Why is
from
Lewis,
Cyber Iceblood.
Why does Lewis like the body pillows, you know, under the covers?
You see, you can't prove that. We have factual evidence that you're a casual.
Video evidence!
I'm pretty sure my buddy Person X, I'm just going to send him your way so he can give you all those Panda Lee news that he posts up on Twitter.
Oh, Jesus. I'm already blind.
I think I need bleach now.
Jesus. Oh.
Just for the eyeballs. Just for the eyeballs.
Yeah, my eyeballs. Oh. I guess that's it. I don't have any more questions left. I don't have any more topics left. Wynnegade, where can we find you on social media?
You can find me on YouTube at Renegade Operative. You can find me on Twitter at Operative Ren. You can find the Cooperative Experience on the channel. I'm pretty sure that you can just put hashtag TCP or TCP in there. TCPHQ, and you'll find the podcast stuff. That's what I've been working on this week. That's what I'm going to be working on next week since we have our premiere episode on August the 14th. And that's the only thing I think I got to plug. I've been doing a shitload of Let's Plays, too, so if anyone want to watch those, they're up on the channel.
You say August the 14th?
Yeah. No! Oh, goddammit!
You got to be a time traveler.
Yeah, I'm going back in the past like Marty McFly, and it's going to happen on August the 14th. But it's going to happen on October.
Okay.
14th.
Yeah. Okay. Well, Wynnegade, I wish you nothing but the best of luck and success on your podcast.
Ren, I would love to be on anytime you want.
Oh, sure, Bane.
It's a little shout out. Sorry.
If we decide to, you know, get Batman on and we need you to break his back, ooh, I'm pretty sure you'd be a great guest.
Yeah.
But yeah, we would love to have you anytime. I think for the second, we're looking for one more person, so we might fill you in for that slot.
Sweet.
Can't
wait. Promise a slander-free environment.
I can't promise that, Lewis, since everyone loves the whole weeboo kick. Maybe you'd be a target. I don't know.
Oh dear.
So looking forward very much to listening to you guys' podcast. Again, I wish you nothing but the best of luck and success on your podcast. Right. If you need any help, I'm always on Twitter or Skype.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, good sir. And it's good to be on your podcast as well. You know, after you beat so many podcasts, you're kind of numb to it. It's like, you know, the whole experience is just a couple of guys talking about some games, talking about some random stuff, having fun. So I think it's going to go pretty well.
Yep. Lewis, welcome. We'll follow you on social media.
All right. I don't actually do anything except shitpost sometimes.
Follow nothing wrong with that.
Twitter, on Twitter, at POTUS.
Oh, yeah.
Sure.
No, my Twitter is at I was a young boy, because I am not good at making usernames.
But you technically were a young boy. There you go.
It is true. I was.
Lewis was a young boy confirmed. Thanks for being on the podcast, Lewis. Bane for you. Welcome to find you on social media.
You can find me pretty much everywhere at Bane for U-Y-U. Like, not you. Yeah, fuck it. You know what I mean. Something I'm also going to shout out for Lester here. On iTunes, you can also get Lester's podcast there. And for anyone wondering, most third-party apps like Podkicker, which I use on Android, support iTunes downloads, so there you go.
Thanks.
Yeah, that's a little bit of a shout-out I want to give.
Thank you for that.
Also, I'm going to announce this here. I'm delaying my... This is how you don't play for a very long while until I get a new working computer. My old one kind of shit the bed last week.
I'm sorry to hear that.
It was on its last leg. The only thing I can do is boot up now and sometimes check Chrome. So,
wow.
Time to take it out back, load up a double barrel, you know, old yeller it, what have you.
Yeah.
But hopefully this delay won't stop it. Thankfully, all the footage I had was saved to a backup hard drive, and the hard drive doesn't seem corrupted. It's just the computer is kind of shit. So yeah, hopefully, at least by January 15th is by the time I plan on having it done, for sure. yeah.
And for, I guess, Mr. Ephraim, you can find his gang on Codec Moments. You can search that on iTunes or on YouTube. And of course, they have a Twitter, at Metal Gear Solid, and they also represent the Metal Gear Solid subreddit. At reddit.com/r/MetalGearSolid. They have a 70,000 strong subscriber base, so yeah, check it out if you like.
Go and make it 70,001. Yeah. There you go.
Definitely. And I thank him so much for coming on tonight.
Oh, yeah.
As for me, you can find me on Twitter at Lester Always. You can find me on Twits at Anokofor, where I stream sometimes. You can find me on YouTube at Tribulation Watts, where the podcast is here, and tomorrow on iTunes at OnoCast. Thank you guys so much for coming on.
Catch up with everything Season 2 premiere.
Yep. Oof.
Season 3 premiere when?
Yep. The first 6 episodes are up right now. Trying to add some more. So,
For anybody on Android or who just wants to get it on a third-party app from iTunes, most apps support it, especially Podkicker, which is a very light and easy one. I recommend that. I use it for pretty much everything, including not just podcasts at this point. So, yeah. Take a look at that. Anything else?
The OnoCast is also on podbay.fm. This does have an Android app, so...
Yeah.
I have a question, actually.
Go ahead.
Is the OnoCast on SoundCloud?
No. It is, but there's only one episode up right now.
If you want, I can edit all of them up and put them up for you.
So if you want,
sweet.
I'll just give you all the audio files.
All right.
Okay. So thanks. I guess it is on SoundCloud now.
Yeah. Soon.
Official confirmation.
We're moving places as we speak.
Hey. See. There we go. Things change constantly. This is how podcasts work.
With the 375 has a question real quick.
Okay.
When will Renegade do the Nico Nico knee?
Oh no.
Yeah, Ren, where are you gonna do that?
Oh boy. Okay, yeah, I said if Lewis will start talking, I'll do this Japanese schoolgirl voice, sometime soon. Is going to be pretty terrible and cringeworthy. I'm not looking forward to it, but yeah, I'm gonna find some way to shoehorn it in, and all you anime loving fappers can jack off or something. I don't know.
It's gonna happen, now, guys.
You're not said anything, man.
Now, now I have a question for you, Ren. When you mentioned you got Battlefield 4, right?
Yes, I do.
I'm gonna ask you to torture yourself, and why don't you stream the entire story of Battlefield 4?
That's interesting. I'll keep that on the back burner and think about it, because
the first mission is okay, and then the rest just dips in quality.
Oh, man, he likes
it. You know what he's playing instead?
What?
Battlefield Hotline.
Well, at least no one said right to hell, yeah.
No, Big Rig Overroad Truckers 48 hour stream.
Oh, fuck you, man. Why you gotta do this to me?
You trying to kill him?
100%
to kill him. No,
it is a descent into madness.
So. This is attempted murder. I'm calling attempted murder right now, and the authorities.
No.
Ren,
no.
Before you do that,
all right, 100% run. Season 2 has already started with a bang. Somebody's calling the cops. That's how close the season premiere was.
Oh boy. Yeah, season 3 will probably end up with somebody setting, like, a building on fire. But a paper mache building, I should explain. Now, season 4 is when we actually set a real building on fire, but it's itself made of paper mache.
Next episode will be 10/13, October 13th, with Kanaki is going to be on. So, that'll be
Would you want to do a post Halo 5 stream? That way I can basically just rant a couple days after it's came out about anything that pisses me off about it.
There's gonna be a lot of Halo 5 spoilers, so I'll make sure I mute that.
When is Halo 5 again?
October 27th.
Yeah, I knew it was October.
I might be moving doing then. So.
Oh, I'm saying, like, after a few days.
Oh.
Maybe like a week after, just so I can get all of the criticisms I have and rant.
We can probably do that during the Fallout 4 podcast.
Ooh. Well, we could do, like, 2 days. 1 day, Halo 5, because I'm pretty sure if they fuck it up, I will have at least a day's worth of material to, like, yell about.
Yeah, we can do that.
And then... hopefully I'll have Fallout 4 by then.
Yeah. We can do that, I think, November 2nd?
Yeah, that'll be good.
If we want to.
Sure.
So that we can have a big old Halo 5 podcast.
Either rant or praise.
Either it'll be explosive or...
Yeah, this could go one of two ways, and I'm not seeing a middle ground here.
So, yeah.
I'll give him benefit of doubt with Master Chief Collection, but, hang on. Somebody posted in the chat. Ren, when will you tell Panda Lee that you love her?
I don't love that bitch. I don't love her.
I hear wedding bells.
Oh, no. You know what you hear? You hear the sound of me running in the opposite direction.
I hear me getting my bells knocked out.
I'm going to knock you out.
The only way she'd be able to get me is she tied me down, and then I'll probably have a vasectomy.
Never know.
I don't know. If she ties your hands, Chicken Slippy of Viagra, I guess. I don't know.
Why the hell is this like a Saw movie? Like, you guys wanted to go Bill Cosby on me now.
No, this is more like, what's that one movie?
My Worst Nightmare?
I don't know. There you go. Bryn's Nightmare.
Oh, I'm gonna be scarred for life. Thank you guys, jackasses.
You're welcome. Blame the chat.
Blame the chat. Says, you can pry her from my cold, dead hands when I get it. Oh, crap.
Victor, yeah, you're gonna take one for the team, buddy. Good job, you know? You wanna give her a touchdown, you know?
Right under this. Hey, Ren, since you wanna fuck Liana, do you wanna have a threesome with her and Phil?
No. Mustafa, go to Mustafa. Mustafa wants to have sex with her.
Oh boy.
I think we should sign off now.
I think we did before we get some.
Oh, there's another question. Ren, why are you so tsundere?
What is a tsundere?
I don't know.
You need your anime.
I don't watch anime. I'm not a weeb,
Lou.
Like,
why are you so hot and cold?
Why do you pretend to hate Liana? Come on.
I'm not pretending. That's it's actually real, but I'm not pretending to weeb, Lou.
Cross swords with Lulu.
Ooh, okay, we can sign off now. I'm about to go.
Can we just stop?
One more for Louis. When is Louis going to give up his minion fetish?
Baking soda.
When is Louis going to give up his minion fetish?
Who the fuck is Louis?
I'll take that as a good answer.
Yeah. Alright. See you guys later. See you next week. Connect will be on, and I don't know.
I will probably be on, most likely.
Yeah.
Unless I'm watching The Flash.
We might be on this week. So, we'll probably talk about stuff. So, thank you guys.
I realize after our outros, we last like another 20 minutes. Right there.
Yeah.
Oh, I have one more thing to get in since this is live. Talk to Kaneki about his fighting games because he loves to masturbate to those as well. Oh, so Street Fighter V discussion for like an hour.
All right, we're gonna have a big old Street Fighter V discussion.
Yeah.
On the owner care, so.
Boy, something I know absolutely nothing about now. Yay.
We might have another Silent Hills discussion as well, so.
Hey, there we go. And then one more insult from a chat, Victor 375. Lewis has a lame voice, to be honest.
That is true.
There you go.
There you go.
Oh, and cool world order. Yeah, and you love to fuck Liana in bed.
Hey, that's lame.
All right, that's what we sign off.
Yeah.
Goodbye, guys. See you guys later.
Slanderous. I'm ashamed.
So,
see ya.
Yep. The end of the slander cast. See you guys later. And
well,
never be game over. See you guys later.
Liana wants rims cream pie. Son of a bitch, we should have waited for that one.